Hi, this is Baker Searles from Mechanical Simulation. In the first part of this Blueprint series, we cover the basics of how Blueprints work with the VehicleSim Dynamics plugin. In this video, we will add a motion sensor and show how to retrieve the acceleration along its x-axis and print it to screen. In the CarSim browser, I have the run control screen open for the stock D-Class sedan packaged with the plugin. You'll notice this is just a vehicle defined, no procedure. Ticking the Show More Options on this screen will add many new fields to add data to this run. Let's pick the top miscellaneous data blue link and add a motion sensor. Click the drop-down library selector to pick the category of custom forces and motion sensors, and select positions, velocities, and accelerations. Let's create a new data set that we'll call Demo Motion Sensor. We'll select one for the number of points specified here, and define one output for the acceleration at the center of the body coordinates, with no orientation adjustments. The home button will head back to the run screen. Whenever CarSim generates files to send to the math model, a sim file is generated. The standard location for this is a file named simfile.sim in the root of your database. Let's specify a different output name for our sim file in the run screen, so it won't conflict with other runs that might be generated from this database. I'll type uesimfile.sim in the yellow field and we're good to go. To connect the movement component to this run, let's go to the database root directory and copy the path to the sim file. Right-click on the file while holding the Shift key will enable the Copy as Path menu item. Back in the Unreal Engine editor, with the car's movement component selected, paste this value into the solver config file field. Now that the pawn is linked to our model data, let's see how we'd access the data from our installed motion sensor. Open the blueprint for the sedan and zoom in to the tick event. In the Components tab, you'll see a list of all the pieces that make up the CarSim demo vehicle pawn. We want to interrogate the model, so drag the CarSim movement component out onto the event graph workspace. Dragging a pin from the movement component will bring up a list of actions you can perform using this object. Type getVSVar and select the interface call of that name from the list. We're interested in the variable axg_s1, so type that into the name field. Testing to make sure the variable was retrieved before using it is probably a good idea. So drag off the return value pin and type isValid. This brings up a variety of validity tests. Under the utility section, there's one that has a question mark icon. This indicates it's a test and branch in the same block, so let's select that. Dragging a pin from the isValid output path, search for and select print string. Putting it along the isValid path ensures we won't try to use the value if it's not contained in the loaded CarSim model. So let's drag another pin from the block that retrieves the value and type getFloatValue and select the interface call. This retrieves the floating point value from the handle to the output variable. Dragging off the return from that, we want to search for the buildString function, which allows us to compose a string to output to screen that prints the value of the variable. So we'll enter a prefix describing the output and drag the return as an input to the print string block from the previous step, which does the actual output. Clicking the down arrow for the print string block shows some additional parameters. So let's only print to screen and set the duration to 1 millisecond so the messages don't stick around and stack up on top of each other. I set things up this way to avoid some complexity, but as an exercise for the viewer, the proper way to do this would be to retrieve the model output variable handles during begin play, cache those as local variables to the blueprint instance, and then just use them during tick. Check out Mechanical Simulation's YouTube channel for more videos about our integration with Unreal or how to use our products. And please visit CarSim.com for detailed technical documentation. Thank you for watching.